Now let's look at the different ways to let text flow around an image. I will recreate this circle-shaped image. In lesson 8, we saw how to do this. I select the ellipse shape. I hold Ctrl press down and drag a circle. Now I right-click on the circle. I go to Convert to and choose Image Frame. I open Colors and click on Stroke. To hide the black border, I click on None. I right-click again on the circle and choose Get Image. I click on Wood and click on OK. In the Image Properties, I click on to Frame Size. I right-click again on the image, go to Preview Settings, and choose Full Resolution. I place the image above the text. In the Properties panel, I open Shape. Here we see several options for text flow. The first option has text flow disabled. I select the second option, text flow around frame shape. Now the circle frame pushes the text away. But text can touch the circle, so I want some extra space around the circle. To do this, click on Edit. The gray line we see around the other circle is called a contour line. So I select Edit Contour Line. If I click on the arrow that points upward, I increase the size of the contour line with 10%. Let's adjust the 10% to 5% and click on it again. I click on OK. Now I activate Text Flow Around Contour Line. Next, let's open a transparent image with an alpha channel. I create an image frame. I right-click and choose Get Image. I select the image with the alpha channel. I right-click and choose Adjust Frame to Image. To create a contour line, I click on Edit. I click on Edit Contour Line. The contour line consists now of 4 nodes. I click on the Add Nodes icon. And I add 4 more nodes. I click on the Move Nodes icon. I drag the nodes to follow the contour of the shape. I click on OK, and click on Text Flow Around Contour Line. To scale the image, keep both Ctrl and Alt pressed down when you scale. Next, let's open a transparent image with a clipping path. I create an image frame again. I right-click and choose Get Image. I open the image with the clipping path. I right-click and choose Adjust Frame to Image. I click on Extended Properties and select the path. I click on OK. I click on Edit. And I click on Edit Contour Line. Because we have a path in the image, I can use this path for my contour line. To do this, I click on Set Contour to Image Clip. I click on OK. I click on Text Flow Around Contour Line. The contour line is the same size as the image, like we had with the circle. So again, we have to make the contour line larger. I click on Edit and click on Edit Contour Line. When I click on the arrow to increase the size, I see for asymmetrical shapes this way of scaling doesn't work well. The contour line doesn't follow the shape proportionally. So we have to do this differently. I click on Cancel. I click on Edit again and click on Edit Contour Line. I will drag with my mouse over nodes at the left side to select them. Then I hold Shift and press the left arrow on my keyboard a couple of times to nudge the nodes to the left. Then I drag with my mouse over nodes at the right side. I hold Shift again and press the right arrow on my keyboard a couple of times. I click on the bottom most node and without Shift press the down arrow one time. I do the same with the topmost node. Now I zoom in on the topmost node by holding Ctrl and scrolling forward. We see this node has a sharp corner. I can make this node smooth and round if I want to. To do this, click on Move Control Points. And then on Move Control Points Symmetrical. When I now drag, I see I can make this node smooth. I click on OK. Again, to scale, hold both Ctrl and Alt press down. Now let's say you have a complex shape, but only an alpha channel. And you would like to use a path, so you don't have to draw it in Scribus. In GIMP, open the transparent image that doesn't have a path yet. right-click on the layer, and choose Alpha to Selection. Open the Paths window. Then click on the Selection to Path icon. GIMP now creates a path from the selection. Save the image as a TIFF. I open the image in Scribus. And adjust the frame to the image. Click on Extended Properties. And select the path that GIMP made. Go to Edit, and select Edit Contour Line. Then click on Set Contour to Image Clip. And click on OK. As before, you can now nudge the contour nodes to the sides. In the next lecture, we will start looking at text frames.